What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. Guys, today we're going to be talking about the one, the only Eula. Yeah, I made like a million videos already. Just bear with me for a minute, okay? First of all, Eula is coming very soon, and by very soon, I mean less than 6 days. Yeah, so 5 days, 14 hours. Yeah, she's coming really soon, and I'm just gonna be talking about in this video just a few things that you should be considering before you summon on her banner and hoping that you get her, of course. So yeah, the number one thing I tell everyone if they ask me, oh, should I summon for Eula, is, well, how many primer gems do you have? Because this is the number one thing in everyone's mind. It's like, oh, I need this many primer gems to get this character, and I need to save this much for this whoever. Yeah, so if you do not have enough primer gems, just don't summon it. Don't do it. Save for a character that's, save for someone that you can guarantee, because if you just summon, you know, without guaranteeing a character, it's just hopeless and wishful thinking. And I don't want to make you guys summon, just because I'm making a lot of videos on, I don't want to make you summon on something that you technically do not need, you technically should be saving, and just a lot of, you know, matters and points come together that I don't really talk about a lot in my videos, and I guess which I should. So yeah, please don't try to summon her just because, oh, she's like the best character in the game, I should probably summon. Well, if she is the best character in the game, that's another story, but she's obviously not, and she's going to be a physical damage dealer, guys. So please keep that in mind as you do whatever you want to do, as you, you know, think about pulling her and stuff. She's a physical damage dealer. Yes, right now she is strong because for some reason MiHoYo is like, oh, we're buffing the physical damage dealer because, well, I don't know, I kind of want to. And that's sort of annoying to me, because if they do that, it kind of shows a character falsely. It doesn't show the real character and how they actually function without the whole, oh, I'm buffed because I have 75% more damage on my Spiral Abyss. And I feel like that's a little unfair for everyone to think that, because she's going to depreciate over time, especially when thinking about the new update that's coming, which is what I'm going to be talking about here in a second. But yeah, please just remember she is a physical damage dealer, so keep that in mind before you summon. You're like, wait, no, I could build her for Cryo. Yeah, I guess you could, but her whole kit suggests that she would use physical damage, and that's how you could output most of her damage per second. So if you were going to build her, I would assume you're going to build her as a damage dealer. So please keep that in mind for, you know, before summoning on her. Anyways, we're continuing on here. So something I'm going to mention is, try her out. Eula is going to come out in the trials, in the trial runs. So please try the trial runs before you try summoning on her. That's what I'm going to be doing. Even though I really, really, really want to use her, and I'm going to summon for her almost guaranteed. Just because she's a fun unit. She looks really fun, and that's the only reason I'm going to be summoning for her, because she looks fun. And I want to play with fun characters that I think I'll enjoy the game more if I had them. That's literally the only reason. And yeah. Anyways, try her out. Try her trial. Get those 23 Primer Gems, which are very nice. But yeah, please try her out. It's going to be very helpful to make a decisive decision. So, you know, it would help you in your future endeavors if you want to summon on another banner. Just make sure you guys do that. Anyways, so something else I also wanted to mention is, don't summon just because she might be a meta character or whatever it may be that, oh, she's gonna be the strongest, you know, as I said earlier. You kind of want to summon characters that you like. Summon on characters that you like playing. The only person that I would say that you should summon 100% on is Ganyu. That's it. That's all I'm gonna say. If a Ganyu banner comes out, summon on it. You're gonna get the best character in the game. But ignore that. Ignore what I said. Just make sure you guys know what you're doing by spending your Primer Gems in this, because you can't take them back. The Primer Gems you spend, you cannot take them back. You're gonna have to grind for so many hours. Of course, if you're free to play. but if you're pay to win, you're probably just gonna summon on her because you paid. And that makes sense. That's all right. Everyone has their own niche and their own stuff to do. Anyways, so I wanted to tell you about, 1.6 is gonna come, so you're gonna get a whole new region in Azuma, and you're gonna get the Electro buff as well as some other elemental reactions, which is like Swirl and other elemental infused in Electro. Basically what I'm trying to say, any Electro type infusion is going to be affected, such as Overloaded or Swirl or whatever it may be, it's going to be affected, and that's going to affect future character damage outputs. So please make sure you guys know what you're doing before you summon on it. So you don't want to summon, Eula does big boy damage. Well, is she going to do big boy damage in the future? Or is she just going to do big boy damage now? And if so, does that really matter? Maybe to you. For me, I don't really care about doing a million damage or 90 million damage. I really don't care about that. As long as I have fun using the character, I have fun using the unit, I'll summon on them and try to get them with the best of my abilities. It's just a matter of preference, how you like playing, what you want to play as. That's it. If you guys like a character, then go for them. If you don't, I don't see the reason why you should be trying to go get them. Anyways, the last but not least, summon on her not just to power up your team, because she is a cryo unit, so you gotta make sure you build upon that, you build upon her physical damage. The team you're gonna be using has to have super conduct, so you can lower the physical damage resistance. All of that comes into consideration, not to mention her constellations. What if you don't get any constellations? It's highly likely that you don't, because it's kind of hard to getting a 5-star, especially a 5-star with constellations. I have 0 5-stars with constellations, except for, Kiching. Not to mention, Kiching is getting a buff, however, she's a physical damage dealer right now. Of course, you could build her for Electro, but I have never personally seen it more effective than the physical that she does, just because Electro isn't really the best right now, which is unfortunate, it's unlucky, but it is what it is. Anyways, guys, I hope I didn't rant on for too long, but please, guys, if you guys enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel. And if you want more videos like this, consider liking as well. Comment on my video asking any questions. I'll do the best I can to comment and reply to them all. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys do enjoy. See you in the next video tomorrow, same time, same place. Goodbye.